Somebody once told me in a conversation, the body does not exist. I said, okay, let's do an experiment, you know. You go throw yourself in front of a train, okay? If you survive, then we know that the body is an illusion. If you don't survive, then we know that the body is real. You see, we live in a world where if you say it's an illusion and you deal with it this way, you will pay the price, you know, you will not survive. So it's not an illusion in the sense that it does not exist as a physical entity. But how we experience it is an illusion. Why? Because we learn to experience our body. You know, I once described in a video that we literally learn about the body, you know, we give it labels. This is eyes, nose, hands, legs, heart, you know, lungs, okay? And this is what you experience. But when thinking is not there, the words are not there, you know, the body will disappear. Not as a physical entity, it will continue, you know, to act, to be in the world. It's a very intelligent organism, you know, it does not wait for thinking and thought and our interference to survive. But it does not know that it is there. It does not know that it exists. The feeling of existence comes through learning about it. When I went through this event where the inner self voice was silent, my body literally disappeared. You know, I looked, I saw something here, but I didn't know it's a hand. You know, I didn't feel I have a body. I looked, I didn't know what I'm looking at. So, and if I'm looking, you know, like in front of me, then I feel that there is nobody at all, you see? So you cannot perceive it. There is no perception of a body. But it does not disappear in a sense that is even in that state, you know, if you're walking and there is no experience, no sense of a body, and you meet, for example, a danger, the body will react, you see, immediately to the danger. It will not, you know, say, oh, I don't exist, you know, does it matter? You see, and now they have done experiments in neuroscience where they can make you easily, you know, through visual touch stimulation to make you experience being in another body, even in the body of a mannequin, you know, to feel that this body is yours. So if it's real, you know, the way we experience it, you cannot be outside, you know, and feel that you are in somebody else's body or in a mannequin's body or so on. So they can easily now do it because it is a learned experience, giving name to these touch visual stimulations that we have, you know, during our childhood. So if you manipulate this, you will be in another body, somewhere else. So this is what they call, you know, out of body experience. It is a natural phenomenon. It's not something, you know, like spiritual, to be out of your body.